As we film today's episode, we are celebrating the autumnal equinox. It is the official transition from summer to fall. For many of us, that transition did happen over Labor Day weekend, but we're celebrating it today. So on today's show, we'll be having a visit from Nadine Heaps of Wait, We're All in This Together, to talk to us about her organization and how it benefits Ashland. We will have our selectmen's update from the meeting held on Wednesday, September 21st. And of course, we'll have our around the town tour. And we'll be doing that with an extended visit at Ashland Day, which happened at Stone Park on September 19th. So stay with us and we'll be right back with the selectmen's update. Welcome back to Around the Clock. It's time for the Selectmen's Update. This is for the meeting that was held on Wednesday, September 21st at Ashland Town Hall. The Selectmen did start with an executive session to review some purchases of property as well as a settlement, which I'll be talking about a little bit later. We opened the meeting with citizens' participation, and we were visited by some fire explorers who had used the grant money from our BAA grant program to do some training in Chicago, and they shared a picture and a little bit of their experience in that. We then moved into some appointments. We had a presentation by Greg Enos, our human resources director. Our viewers got to meet Greg on our last episode of Around the Clock, so he gave the full Board of Selectmen an update on the projects that he's been working on since he's been hired, some of the positions that he has filled, and some of the ones that he is working on. There's been some turnover in town. We're getting a new public works director. Actually, an old public works director is coming back. Doug Small will be joining us in October. We're in the process of looking for a new planner. We hired an assistant planner. So Greg has been very busy, not only putting some new programs and policies in place, but hiring some new staff. We also had an update from Cliff Wilson regarding the Warren Woods District. So there is an organization or a committee. It's called the Warren Woods Ad Hoc Committee. It was created a number of years ago when Warren Woods was acquired by the town, and we were looking at what to do there. They have now increased their sort of scope to include 22 Elliott Street, which is a house that was given to the town as a gift from the Green Company. And one of the decisions that we did make last night was we have allotted up to $10,000 from funds that were given to us by the Green Company to do some cleanup and improvement and button up 22 Elliott Street for the winter to make sure the heating and electricity and things like that work. If you have any interest in what's going on there, the Warren Woods Ad Hoc Committee does have public meetings. You can check the agenda and the town meeting, the town website for when they meet if you'd like to give some input on what could be happening at that property. We then went into our old and new business, and we had a very detailed discussion of the selectmen's goals that we had set about a year ago, and a number of them have been completed. We got an update from the town manager on what still needs to be worked on. If you want to get all the details, you can go ahead and watch the selectmen's meeting to see where we're at with specific projects. We started looking at a regulation for some towing. Right now here in town, we don't have much towing. We have a lot of no parking signs, but some of those are not deterrent enough, and we have seen some areas in town where parking has become very difficult and unsafe. So we're going to be looking at a new towing regulation. So you may see some no parking and tow zone signs going up in the near future. So be on the lookout for those. And if you have any questions, feel free to reach out to any of us at the town manager's office and selectman's office. We approved the license for two wineries at the Ashland Farmers Market for the September 24th Wine and Cheese Fest. 1634 Meadery and Coastal Vineyard will be joining the festivities on that day. We also discussed the extension of the stage two water restrictions. We are almost close to having our approval. I'm sorry, we do have our approval for an emergency water connection through Southboro through the MWRA. We are in the process of determining when we're going to turn that on. And what will happen is we will turn that on to help our wells and the water levels of our wells recharge. What we have done is we have prohibited all outdoor watering as of right now. That means no watering, even with a hose, on your gardens. If you have rain barrels, feel free to use those. But because of the restrictions and because of the low water levels and the drought that's in effect in all of Massachusetts, we have restricted all outdoor watering. We approved the name of the RTD, so the project that's going up on the MBTA road. The name of their street is going to be Cirrus Drive, C-I-R-R-U-S Drive. It's as if you're going to be in the clouds and up there on the hill, it might seem that way. We discussed our BAA fall grant round. We discussed how much money we had, how much we're going to be using. And there are going to be some slight modifications. The applications for that grant round will be going out soon. You'll be getting a notification from Susan Roby in the Selectman's office. And there'll be some new questions asked if you've received money from us in the past. We talked about the Nyanza Advisory Group. This is a group that will include a member of the Board of Health, a member of Planning Board, Conservation, and two selectmen, and two people at large, two citizens, to discuss the issues at Nyanza. So if you're interested in participating, please submit a talent bank form. We also appointed Regina Purimetla. She is working in our Public Works Department. She will be part of our Road Traffic Safety Committee appointment. She will be a member of that group. We had a town manager appointment. We had a call firefighter appointed, and his name is Jess Briggs, so he'll be joining. We then went into our town manager's report. We talked again about the emergency water connection, and that's been done. We talked about a strategic planning advisory group that the town manager is pulling together. He is still looking for a few more people to be part of that group, so if you're interested, fill out a talent bank form. He'd love to have someone from the Route 126 or condo area, and also from the community, the business community. So if you have some time and you'd like to be participating in the discussion about the vision and strategic view of Ashland, please reach out and fill out a talent bank form. We got an update on our 2017 budget. There have been some issues at the high school. They need to put in a new boiler, so we talked about how that's going to be funded. We then also talked about some mediation that's going to be happening with our Board of Health. We approved the funding for that. Just to help things work a little bit more smoothly on that board. There was a lot of discussion on many of these items, so if you'd like to see more detail, go ahead and catch the replay of the meeting. The last thing I just want to remind people is that the last day to register to vote is October 19th. You can do it either at the Ashland Town Hall or online. Lots of important election items coming up. Local ballot questions. So if you're not registered but you're interested in participating, make sure you register before October 19th. So that's it for this Selectman's update. I will be right back with more Around the Clock. Welcome back to Around the Clock. We have a very special visitor today. We have Nadine Heaps. Nadine, welcome to Around the
Clock. Thank you.
Nadine is here to talk to us about her program called WAIT. We are all in this together. Nadine, I know you're very excited to talk about it, but before we get into that, tell us a little bit about yourself. How long you've been in town, your connection with Ashland.
I moved to Ashland in 1986. And immediately was invited by Terry Evans and Dave Foster to come get involved with their initiative to start recycling in Ashland, because we just used to throw everything out then.
Right.
And John Ellsworth asked me to come help on another project, and I just loved the community immediately. You felt welcomed when you came to Ashland. There was always people welcome you to get involved with a whole bunch of different things.
And that's certainly still true. I mean, we have such a large volunteer group here in Ashland. I mean, and there's so many things that are volunteer-based that people don't even realize. I mean, the farmers market completely volunteer run, and it's such a huge thing every Saturday.
It's over 200 just in Ashland that weight's collectively given to.
Wow. Okay, so wait, we're all in this together. How did the idea start?
Marsha Rennie was working for me at Purple Ink Insurance, and I wanted to keep her on board, so I looked at her wish list of what she wanted her job to include, and everything on it had to do with community and giving back and making a difference and helping other people. And I thought, oh, well, that's not insurance, really. I think that that's something else, and I want Marsha to help me with this, so she'll be happy to work here. And so we took the idea of, back in September of 2014, first with Honto. Mm-hmm. And the new owners, great food, really great people, good location, very clean. And he said to me one night, I wish that I could be involved with all the different things in town, but I work here. I'm here 100 hours a week. I said, well, you don't have to actually be involved. You can contribute. And I know everybody in the organizations right. you should be giving to, so why don't I just help you give to those organizations? And would you allocate 1%, just 1%? And he said, of course, that sounds fantastic. So Honto was my guinea pig. Mm-hmm. And September 2014, we chose 30 organizations together. I sat down and made a list of everything Purple Ink Insurance had given to in the past, and I presented it to Ray and Kevin, the owners, and I explained a little bit about each one. And he picked some that sounded interesting, and we went from there.
Wow. So now, 2 years later.
2 years later.
You went from one business participating, and how many businesses do you have participating now?
We have 16 currently. However, I haven't asked any one of them to join. They've all asked. And in the process, I've sold the insurance agency mm-hmm. and am now ready to work on this full time.
So this is a business for you. I know for
Correct.
Some people they weren't sure that it was, they thought it was a nonprofit.
No.
So how does it work as a business for you?
I'm a firm believer that good business is good for a community, and that if you have a for-profit business and you can actually figure out how to make a profit, then you can make a bigger difference in your community. Mm-hmm. So Wait is a for-profit business, eventually. And what our goal is to help other businesses and match them up to form relationships with different community groups.
Now, how many community groups is your organization helping donate to?
Each month it averages about 125 different organizations. However, we have, I think we're at 228 organizations that have received weight checks from our weight member businesses.
And how do you determine those organizations?
Great question. Each of our business members have different parameters for how they do it. Ray and Kevin and May from Honto pretty much once a month might say, late at night, he'll text me, oh, make sure you add this one on and that one. And it's probably because somebody from that organization is at Honto talking to him. But other than that, it's pretty much everyone, to cycle everyone through, we want to contribute. Other organizations are more purposeful and directed, and we'll choose the same ones for 6 months. Bill Goldberg from Main Street Wine and Spirits really likes to focus, so he'll choose 30 organizations, commit to those exact 30 for 6 months, and then when there's 31 days, he'll double up even on some of the organizations. So every different business has come up with a unique way of how it feels comfortable to them.
Now, I know you create monthly calendars for each of the businesses, and we have a couple of them here. So let's pull up this one.
So that's the Purple Ink July of 2016 calendar. And since Matt DeSimone, he's the new owner of Purple Ink, mm-hmm. he agreed to continue the commitment in
nice.
Our community. He's not open on Saturdays and Sundays, so he commits to each day a different organization. And half of them are Ashland, and half of them are now Spencer, because he and his family, he has a wonderful wife and four children, they live in Spencer.
Oh, nice.
So he's kind of introducing this out there, but still keeping his support to our community.
Great, great. Now we have another one. Because now I know some of them get done on a weekly basis.
Mm-hmm.
I personally use Glam Salon, and
Fantastic.
I know when I walk in. So here's another one. This is Honto's.
This is Honto, yeah. And so they do one a day because it depends on the business size. If you're a small business like a Glam, you one a day, you're going to 1% is,
right.
you know, you don't want to feel like you're sending somebody 25 cents. You want
right.
to be making some difference. So Glam, for instance, on this week, will have one organization
right.
in particular.
Right.
But Honto pretty much does one a day. This is their August giving calendar.
So in regards to the check, right, how does that happen? Does the business do the check? Does that go through you? How does the funding happen?
We've been evolving. We're trying to make WAIT much more useful for businesses, mm-hmm. and to also, we recognize that businesses, like organizations, they just don't have enough time in the day. Organizations are all volunteer, and yeah. businesses are doing all the jobs themselves, especially if the dishwasher's out sick, there they are washing the dishes. Right. So they just don't have the time, so we're trying to simplify. We suggest that the business gives us one check for the total of the month, and then the business can choose. Like with Honto, they specifically do each day, so that if you are the Ashland Fire Department Association and you get your friends to go in there for dinner, it's going to help to get the donation to be bigger. Other organizations like Bill Gath and Judy Lira, they're real estate agents. There's no way you could plan your closing for the week that's going to be the Arts Alliance, you know, Ashland's, or any of the different organizations. So it becomes a commitment to an amount. And then it's evenly divided. Okay. And then as their business continues to grow, their donations are more generous over time.
So how, as the citizens of Ashland, how can we support this? Because many, many people in town are benefiting from this through the different organizations that they're a part of, whether they're part of the Ashland Community Theater or the PTO or any of these other organizations. How can citizens support this program?
Okay, there's three ways. One is if you see, we just got WAIT emblems, so we're going to be putting our WAIT static cling emblems on that they're a WAIT member. Make sure you thank the business. Just say to the business, thank you for being a WAIT member. We appreciate your commitment to giving. If you're part of an organization, I know you're on all different kinds of boards and you've had your sleeves rolled up for years. So when you go in, look at the calendars and say, oh, this one, these three I'm involved with. Ask to speak to the owner. Tell the owner, if you don't know them, if they don't know you, hi, I'm Yolanda. I just wanted to tell you that these are the three organizations I'm on, and we appreciate it. Business owners are not giving to receive. They're giving because it's the right thing, and they want to change the conversation. So they're not expecting you to rush in and use their services. Thank yous. Amazing. But what has happened naturally is the more donations you receive, the more you want to check out the business.
Right. And I know, so you have Hantu, I know you have GLAM, you mentioned Bill Gath. Any other types of organizations involved?
We do. We have Backstage Dance now, Ashland Threading Spa, Needham Bank is our welcome basket sponsor. We have also Main Street Wine and Spirits. It does 1% of all of his wine sales. Wow. I know I'm leaving out somebody, and I feel terrible. We have brand new O'Hanna Stein from Ashland Reiki and Wellness Center, Ooh. Who's opening up where the old red dress was. Yeah. And she also has a gift shop of things that are spiritual and handcrafted and locally made. So it's all New England based. So if you're an artist or a craft person, you want to sell some stuff there that fits her where she's going with this, please go visit her.
Yep. That's on Front Street. It's where, again, where the red dress used to be. It's the Masonic building?
Yeah, yeah, exactly. It's beautiful. She's invested an awful lot in our town. She had the floors refinished. She repainted. She has gorgeous oriental carpets in there. We really want her to stay in business, so go visit and say hi. You're there from WAIT. Another thing is if you're part of an organization, this morning I was meeting with the preschool PTO, Terry, is the treasurer. And so now what she's thinking is, oh, here's all the events that we're having this year. We're having a pumpkin fest, we're having a pajama party. How can I tie the businesses that keep sending us all these donations into our events? Not asking for more money, for free stuff, but, let's invite Backstage Dance to come to the pajama party. And so we were just brainstorming all kinds of out-of-the-box ideas, and that's a lot of fun. So if you're an organization and you want help getting matched up with the different businesses, and then more importantly, now that I'm ready to go, WAIT's ready to grow, we're looking for more businesses that believe that giving is the right thing to do and that 1% is not a lot and that if you do it for the right reasons, it comes back tenfold.
Nice. So you're looking to grow. What other next steps are there for WAIT?
We have three awesome people that have jumped on board to help with weight. We've signed up for a Damon John Launch Academy program that we're working on, and we're going to be presenting in November. So we're preparing for that. We have somebody from his team coming out next week to work with us for 2 days. Bill Carson, local resident and very involved person, has decided that he's going to give me all of his strengths, and there are none of those are mine. And he's a systems person, so he's jumped on board, and he's helping weight grow because he saw that if he, instead of working with one or two organizations, if he helped weight, it could help the entire community. Right. And then Judy Lehrer has jumped on board, and she's doing all of our promotional materials, and she's helping with a lot of the direction, and she's more of the fine tuner of things. I'm like, oh, let's have some more ideas. And she's like, wait a second, let's. And then Terry Weiser has had her heart in the program since the very beginning. And the reason I have the businesses is almost all from Terry, because Terry will go to, she's a member. Terry Weiser's a member too, the embroidery place.
Right.
I didn't mean to overlook. And there's three other people I'm forgetting too, so I should have brought.
So I'm taking, she did your shirt.
She did the shirt, yep.
That's a really
it's
nice
wonderful,
design.
This is our logo.
Yeah, yeah.
New logo, it's the three primary colors. Notice no purple. But it's the three groups, everyone benefits.
Right. Right.
It's the business, the community, and then the organization.
Now you had something else to show us, the Needham Bank.
Oh, I'm so excited. Our Weight Welcome program, and Needham Bank is the current sponsor. And this is our second trial run, but now what we're going to do is every other month we want to welcome our Ashland residents. And the old-fashioned days, somebody would come over and bring you some cookies.
Yeah.
When you know. But now with electronics, we've become a more insulated community, and nobody gets welcomed. And now you don't know which dentist to go to. Dr. Zarell is a member. You don't know who to go to or what to do. But if your neighbor comes over and says, oh, here's the best mechanic, here's the best this, here's the best that, you start saying, oh, what about, oh, okay. So we're welcoming new residents, people that have moved into town in August. We're going to start delivering the baskets. They're currently located at Needham Bank.
Okay.
So if anyone has just moved new to Ashland, bought a house, purchased a condo, or is new, never lived in Ashland before and is renting, they can go to Needham Bank and pick up their basket. They're filled with all kinds of gift certificates and coupons from all the different member businesses.
Nice.
And some of our non-member businesses just want to welcome people to the community. So they were allowed to put their items in as well. And then in the green bag, we have all kinds of community information so that a new resident can immediately get involved with things that interest them or reach out to the groups that might be able to help them with questions and problems they have.
Right.
So it's been a lot of fun. I can't wait to start delivering them this weekend. And so Needham Bank actually, since they're the sponsor, they bought the recycling bins because the town doesn't give them to us for free. They're $5, still a good deal. Needham Bank paid for all 48 of this round of them.
Nice.
So thank you, Needham Bank. Yeah, very exciting. It's so fun to come and bring a present to somebody.
Yeah.
And it's all good stuff.
Right. Oh, good. So it sounds like it's all such great stuff. So where are you going from here? You're talking about growing it, but I can tell you have other big visions. What's your big vision moving forward?
Well, the first thing I want to do is to make sure that we make weight work well here so that we are over-delivering our promise to the businesses to help them connect to the community and that we're over-delivering to our promise to the organizations that we're going to help match them and get them help so they don't have to constantly ask and beg the businesses, change the conversation, and we're doing that. The conversation has changed. A wonderful story was Nick's Pizza. People used to come in all day long asking, oh, I have this auction, can I have a free gift certificate? And it's overwhelming for a small business owner, especially when the person asking, they've never seen you come in and buy pizza. It's kind of nervy to be asking for free things when you're not even a customer. He signed up to the weight program, and about 3 weeks into it, he called me and he said, I just want you to know, I think it was for the Ashland Emergency Fund auction, somebody came in and bought 4 gift certificates. They didn't even ask me for a free one. I just want you to know, I appreciate that so much. So another way you can help is just think local. buy gift certificates at town. So I want to make Ashland work. I think our number is 40. If we have 40 businesses and now wait turns into a profitable business model. But we're still in so much transition, I'm not sure the right number. But I want to make wait work in Ashland. And then I want to make the systems so easy to duplicate that we could take it to any community. And I'm sure that once you take a model like this to any community, that the community's unemployment rate will go down, that the community organizations will be better funded, that businesses will be more successful. It just naturally happens that way.
Right, right. Well, I have to say, knowing that a small business is helping other businesses is very exciting, and that we're getting those businesses to do more charitable giving, because I think for a lot of people, they keep hearing, people need more help, let's, you know, ask the government for help. And that is not going to be something we can keep sustaining. Mm-hmm. Whereas if we can support businesses to support the community who then supports the businesses back, that's such a great model that, as you said, can then be replicated other places.
I wanted to share the frustration about the government. We started talking about it earlier,
right,
in that I understand the whole last yes and no issue and so forth. A lot of the things on the table were very important. There was no doubt about it. But what's very difficult in government is that you're trying to get everyone to pay for what the people that love the library and the schools love, and it's really difficult. And you keep asking and asking. There's a tipping point, like you were saying.
Right.
But with business, if you think about the velocity of money and you think about what happens the more everyone gives, what can happen if it's just a little bit?
Yeah.
And then that way, businesses are giving to things that are important to them. It's not even about what's in town. Billy supports Crohn colitis and also juvenile diabetes. I don't know particularly why, but those are important issues to him and his family and employees at his store. So if you, again, it's changing the conversation.
Right.
And I think that's awesome. Another thing that Wait wants to do is to really respond more directly to community needs. So businesses need more business, organizations need more money, new residents need to be welcome, and then it brings me to my question is, what do you think Ashland's biggest needs are?
I think we have seniors in our community who have some real needs, who maybe out of pride do not go and ask. I don't know if there are any senior center organizations or senior initiatives that are part of the giving. I think Friends of the Council on Aging are certainly are one of the people who benefit from the program. I also think there are some younger families that might be having some issues. And it's not big, it's not a lot of people, but I know our recreation department always has people asking for scholarships to go to their camps. I think there are needs for sports fees or even bus fees within our community, that people are making the decision, I'm going to drive my child to school versus putting them on the bus. And maybe there's something there that we could help people with.
Mm. I didn't want to not mention Mexico City.
Mexico City
has also been wonderful. They were the fourth business to join. I'm thinking there's still two more I have to come up with. It was easy when it was just two. It was Purple Link and Hot Dough, and then it became Purple Link, Hot Dough, and Nick's. And then, so I wanted to mention that. I like these new ideas. They're all really important issues, you know. And I think it's not just pride with seniors, too. How much does a family ask for?
Right.
You know, I think we all as humans have that challenge of what it is we need versus what we're willing to work for versus what is available.
Yeah.
It's the ultimate question.
Well, I want to thank you first for coming on
Around
the Clock.
Thank you.
But thank you for doing what you do with Wait. I think it's a great organization. I love that it is a business helping other businesses helping our community, because to me, that's what it's about. It's about not relying on the government, but relying on people to do the right thing and realize that there is a benefit to giving back. And from a volunteer standpoint, we've really had that in Ashland, and it's nice to see this. And I hope to have you back in 6 months when you tell me that you've moved this on to your next community, because I really see that happening. And it's just very exciting, and I support you, and just thank you for what you do for Ashland.
Thank you for what you do. And I wanted to share with you another probably early on thought on the whole thing is Miss Fogg, my eighth grade teacher, stood on the table on our first day of class, and she was a little thing and much older than we were, and she started yelling out the preamble. We, the people of the United States, and she made us memorize it. And she every day reminded us that the government is you.
Yep.
Don't complain. Roll your sleeves up and get involved. You don't have to be in government, but if you're involved, then you don't have so much to complain about because you're busy making the difference, and it can be little. It's all about us all just doing a little.
And I think the other thing for people to realize is, as you said, you don't have to be in the government to help move things along.
Right.
And, you know, you don't have to be taking the big steps to try and be in big positions. It's little things. Here in Ashland, there's so many boards and committees that need people, that need input and help and just guidance, even if it's just one or two meetings where you can go and say, this is what I see for Ashland, or this is what I can do to help move this project along. And I think it's so important.
Thank you for having me on.
I
look
for
forward to
here.
Welcoming new businesses on board, and I look forward to helping the organizations better. And I love the relationships that are forming. I should have been a matchmaker.
So before I let you go, if a business is watching this, or if someone's watching it and they either want to bring their business to you or somehow get their organization involved, how do they get in touch with you to get involved?
Nadine@waitforcommunity.com. Or just find the purple building on Main Street, and then I'll be there.
Okay. Well, Nadine, thank you very much.
Thank you, Yolanda.
I hope you've enjoyed this segment, and please check out what Wait is doing, and we'll be back with more Around the Clock.
Welcome back to Around the Clock. It's time for our Around the Town tour. We're going to start at Stone Park for an extended look at Ashland Day. This was the 31st Ashland Day that was celebrated, and the estimates are about 11,000 people went through throughout the day. They were there from 9 to 4. A couple things to mention. We would like to congratulate the Duca family. Hilda Duca, who passed away back in June, was given the Grand Marshal Award. And Walter Wally Brewer was given the Citizen of the Year Award by the Ashland Day Committee. Also, we did something new. We had live streaming from the gazebo all morning. So we'd like to thank Paul Santolo from Comtrex Corporation for allowing us to do the live stream from the gazebo. If you weren't able to make it to Ashland Day, hopefully you were able to watch part of it live. And if you didn't catch it, you can go and see the footage and see some of the things that you might have wanted to see, some of the performances by backstage dance, as well as the presentation of the awards. I would also like to thank Jemai Youssef, who spent some time at Ashland Day interviewing and walking around and talking to people. It was great reconnecting. She graduated back in 2012 from Ashland High School, and it was nice to see her back and working with us at WACA-TV, as well as the other camera crews that worked that day, including Todd Carter. So here's some great footage from Ashland Day.
Welcome to Around the Clock Ashland Day Edition. I'm your host, Yolanda Greaves, and I have with me today Jemai Youssef.
Hi, I'm Jemai, and I'll be helping to do some of the interviews here at Ashland Day today.
So, as Jemai said, she's going to do some of the interviews. We're going to show you some of the great things that are happening here at Ashland Day. And if you see our crew, hopefully you stopped by and have told us your favorite things about Ashland Day.
Enjoying Ashland Day.
Hi, we're having a really good time today.
What have you guys done today?
We had some lunch, sat on the hill in the shade and enjoyed that. We've been hitting a lot of the booths, checking out a lot of the local businesses. We've been watching karate demonstrations and dancing and just having a really good time in the sunshine.
Awesome. You think you'll come back next year?
Definitely. Absolutely.
My name is Tom Heggie. I'm with the Ashland Lions Club.
And what is the Ashland Lions doing at Ashland Day today?
We're cooking. We're cooking hot dogs, hamburgers, hot pastrami, We're here every year for as long as Ashland Day has been. And the money we raise here goes to help our global cause, which is to fight blindness.
I'm here with
Amy Turncliffe from the Decisions at Every Turn Coalition in Ashland.
And what are you doing at Ashland Day today?
We have a booth here to show Ashland community members and surrounding community members about the educational materials and opportunities to volunteer with our coalition, which is focused on preventing youth substance abuse in Ashland.
And I hear you are part of the organizers for the Farmers Market?
That's correct. I'm one of the founders of the Farmers Market, along with a group of dedicated folks here in town. And this is our fifth year of the existence of the Farmers Market, our second year here at Ashland Day.
And so how do you organize it so the Farmers Market and Ashland Day kind of happen together?
So we 2 years ago, we sat down with the Ashland Day Committee and we talked about the potential for collaborating and having all these events here at Stone Park. Ashland Day certainly is, you know, such a signature event for the town. It's the 31st, today is the 31st Ashland Day, and we agreed that the basketball court would be the best location. We come and lay out the basketball court to accommodate all our vendors, and here we are. It's a beautiful day.
Hi, I'm here with Mr. DiGeronimo, and when I was in high school, he was a teacher, but now I hear you the principal?
I'm the principal of the middle school, yes, and I'm going on 5 years this spring.
Awesome. And so what are you doing here at Ashland Day?
Supporting the many community organizations that have booths here. I'm a member of the Decisions of Every Turn Coalition, which helps prevent substance abuse for our community and tries to get our youth involved in that process. So they're here, as well as many other community organizations. And just a lot of middle school students come to visit the booths and have some fun. It's nice to see them, and it's a great day.
Chris Avery,
who is a coach for the track team. And so what are you doing here at Ashland Day?
I am wandering around pestering people and letting them know that we have, in its infancy, we just started 2 years now, the Ashland Athletics Hall of Fame. And we are out here promoting our first banquet, which is November 20th. And we have tickets available. Come support your local athletes. Come nominate local athletes. If you have a past friend or your father or your mother, your sister, your brother, who's been a great athlete in the past, come nominate them for our Hall of Fame.
The Grand Marshal's Award this year is going to a young lady who was born in Winthrop. Her parents were John and Alice Dorr. She held two masters in special education from Calvin College. She worked for the town of Marlboro as a special education teacher, and she worked for the New England Center for Children with Autism in Southboro. Hilda Duca passed on June 6th. She was a long time. She was a long time member.
What Bill is trying to say, she was a long time member of the Ashland Day Committee. And she served our community and our committee with pride and honor and distinction. Whenever there was a function that we were holding on, she would be one of the first ones to volunteer. Her family, her friends, her children, they're all important in her life. Also her husband and her family. And we as the Ashland Day Committee feel that we're like her second family. We do miss her. And we miss her, especially on days like today. So it's with great pride and honor on behalf of the Ashland Day Committee to present this Grand Marshal Award in her honor and in her memory to her husband, Michael. Mike.
As you her at the Grand Marshal is being presented in honor of Hilda Duca. Hilda was a person that really helped knit the fabric of Ashland together. That's what I think about with Hilda. She volunteered for so many different things without ever asking for anything in return. And she really helped define the word of what a true community meant. And that is something that is very, very special. As noted, she was dedicated special education teacher in the town of Marlborough, was very active in Ashland Day and so many other things, and she is greatly missed today and every single day. So I have the honor of presenting an official Senate citation to Michael for Hilda being named Grand Marshal for Ashland Day.
It is fitting today that we celebrate the life of Hilda Duca in one of the efforts in supporting this community that she helped perpetuate. This honor named for Hilda Duca, being named the 2016 Grand Marshal for her contributions to the town and her extraordinary dedication through her life, spirit, and memory to our community. And it's signed by the Speaker of the House, Bob DeLeo, and myself as the state representative.
Whereas Hilda Duca has been chosen as the Grand Marshal for all events for the 2016 Ashland Day by the Ashland Day Committee for her dedication to the citizens of Ashland. And whereas Hilda moved to Ashland as a young child, being educated here and meeting her husband Michael prior to graduating from Ashland High School. And whereas Hilda went on to receive a degree in teaching and taught in the Marlborough School District for many years. And whereas Hilda has served the community in many capacities, including being an active member of the Ashland Day Committee, helping her husband organize the summer concerts, and also helping with the Halloween parade and the holiday lighting. And whereas Hilda unfortunately passed away on June 6th, leaving behind her husband Michael and her two daughters, Bethany and Michaela, Hilda made a mark on our community and is missed by many. Now therefore, we the selectmen of the town of Ashland do hereby proclaim Saturday, September 17th, 2016, as Hilda Duca Day. We urge all residents to make their appreciation to her family for their devotion to the town of Ashland.
Wanted to make sure it was okay, but Michael would like to say a few words. Michael Duca.
I'd like to thank everybody, the board members and the people from the town, the state, reps. Knowing my wife, as I know you guys know my wife, she'd be pissed off. Right? She would be. She'd be very pissed off. But I know she's up there watching all of us, so.
Our Citizen of the Year was born in Newton, Mass., where he grew up with his four brothers and one sister. Upon graduating trade school, our recipient enlisted in the Navy. He was stationed at the Naval Base in Brunswick, Maine, where he met and fell in love with the love of his life, whose name was also Hilda. So by now, I think he has an idea who we're talking about, and that would be Mr. Walter Wally Brewer. Yeah, you're right, something was going on. After serving his country with much pride and honor, Wally moved back to Massachusetts, and back in 1959, he purchased his first home in Ashland and moved there with his wife and two small children at the time, Jane and Jimmy. Wally retired as a part-time police officer back in 1996, but yet Wally remained faithful to the men in blue and was very active as a member of the Ashland Auxiliary Police Department. Wally was appointed captain of the Auxiliary Police and held that rank until he retired from the Auxiliary Police Department in 2002. Wally, well, you're standing behind me. Why don't you come up next to me, please? Because I really don't trust you. I've known this gentleman for a number of years, and like I said, I really don't. I knew that was coming. Serving honorably and with distinction for those 32 years. In his spare time, Wally has been a longtime member of the Ashland Lions Club. His humor and quick wit has kept him the meetings and social events sponsored by the Lions always entertaining. Dedicated service to the Auxiliary Police Department and to this town, and that's why the men in blue over there with the Auxiliary Police are there to honor you as well. So, Mr. Brewer, thank you and congratulations as Citizen of the Year.
Senator, and it's dated today, September 17th, 2016. Congratulations, Wally.
All right. Offering its sincerest congratulations to Wally Brewer in recognition of being named the 2016 Citizen of the Year at Ashland Day.
Walter Wally Brewer Day. We urge all residents to make known their appreciation for his devotion to the town of Ashland, and we wish him good health and good fortune, and thank you for all your work.
Hi, I'm here with
Officer Foster.
And so what is the police doing at Ashland Day today?
Well, just supporting the town, and we come every year to Ashland Day, and we show the people the cruisers and what they're paying for and their taxes as far as our cruisers go. We have our police bike here. The other ones are a couple of my bikes that I show. That one there I had built. And then this here is my track bike. But we were also given out helmets and information on some of the programs that the police department's running, things like that. Just trying to make our presence.
Hi, I'm here with
Chief Scott Boothby.
And what are you doing at Ashland Day today?
Hi, we're here. We're just displaying some of our trucks. We have the ladder truck. We have the brush fire truck. We have a rescue truck, and the kids can go in it. They can figure out what's inside and have a good time at it.
Awesome. Well, sounds like a lot of fun. Hi, I'm here with
Joe Mignani
and
Bill Gath.
So, what are you two's role in Ashland Day?
Well, to be honest with you, I'm one of the original members from 31 years ago that helped start this program. I've held the rank of member, co-chair, chair, and treasurer.
Wow. And?
Well, I'm currently chairman. I haven't been around as long as him. I'm not as old as he is. But I also live in Natick.
And do you have any favorite memories of Ashland Day?
You know what I think in retrospect of all the 31 years is the fact that people come and have a great day here. You know, they enjoy coming. It's a family event. It's a community spirit day. And just to see everybody mingle and having a good time and putting politics aside for one day, I think is a cherished memory for me.
Awesome. And do you have a favorite memory?
I like them all. It's a great affair. We have an auction the night before to help support this because you see all these rides out here. We sell ticket bands and tickets and wristbands and don't even come close to covering the cost of the rides. We have a free petting zoo and what have you. So what I like is the fact that, again, everybody comes together. There's no politics. There's an awful lot of people that are willing to work to make this come across, and I'm proud to be associated with them.
Well, thank you so much for your time, both of you.
Well, thank you for being here, and we appreciate all the work that the folks at WACA does And you live streamed it today. That was a surprise for us. This is the first one. That's new. And we're, you know, it's always something different every year. And that was something new, and we greatly appreciate it. So thank you all, WACA, and hope to see everybody next year at 32nd.
Well, I hope you had the opportunity to enjoy Ashland Day. I spent some time there. It was great getting to talk to people. Of course, the farmers market was there. Everything was in one place. Well, that's our Around the Town tour for this episode. If you ever have an event that you'd like to share with us on the Around the Town tour here at Around the Clock, please let us know. We love to share events and stories that are going on in Ashland and or by Ashland families and folks that might be outside of town. So stay with us. We'll be back with our closing remarks and our close for this episode of Around the Clock. Wrap up this episode of Around the Clock, but before we go, a couple of things to make you aware of that are coming up here in Ashland. There is a star party coming up on October 8th. It's still a little way out, and we'll get you some more information. It is happening at the Ashland High School William Cunis Track and Field, and you can go to www.ashlandmass.com to get more information. This is a program being sponsored by the Friends of the Ashland Public Library. There will be telescopes available for you to look up at the night sky from the Ashland High School field. I've also been given information from our police department about a new way to get alerts. It's called Code Red, and in the near future, we will be having our own Ed Berman on to talk about it. But for right now, you can go to ashlandpd.org to sign up for Code Red as a way to get notified of issues here in Ashland. But also, if you are signed up with Code Red and you go to another community that has it, you would get their notifications as well. So again, that is ashlandpd.org to join the database on Code Red. Of course, we have an election coming up on November 8th. Make sure you're registered to vote. Registration closes on October 19th. So reach out to our town clerk's office or go online and get registered to vote. Make sure you check all the calendars in town, PTO, schools, community events. Of course, Ashland Farmers Market is still going on. That'll be going on until the second Saturday in October. All kinds of fun stuff. So enjoy your fall. I want to thank Nadine Heaps from Wait for coming on Around the Clock and sharing the information about her business and how she's giving back to her community. I want to thank all of you for watching Around the Clock, and I hope that if you ever have a story idea, you reach out to me. If you see me, please don't hesitate to say hello, and thank you so much for watching Around the Clock. I'm your host, Yolanda Greaves. Have a great day.